我们现在要开始礼拜五晚上的聚会。
Now we shall begin our Friday evening worship service.
啊，请我们一起来默祷。
Let's all say a silent prayer.
阿门。奉主耶稣的圣名，我们开始晚上的聚会。
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we begin our evening worship service.
啊，唱诗315首。
Let's sing hymn number 315.
啊，感谢主，我们大家啊辛苦的工作啊，六天劳碌做工。
We thank the Lord that we have toiled and labored for 6 days.
我们要进入第七日的安息。
Now we have entered the seventh day, the Sabbath rest.
啊，我们现在一起来祷告，求主带领我们今天晚上的聚会。
Now we shall pray together and ask the Lord to guide our service tonight.
让神的灵带领我们进入真理里面来光照我们。
May God's Spirit lead us into the truth and may His light shine upon us.
啊，我们每一天的生活都活在神的道理里面。
May every day of our lives be to be lived in His word.
我们现在一起祷告，那时间到我就摇铃。
Now let's pray together. When time's up, I'll ring the bell.
Ah, 今天晚上跟大家一起从《生命记》来查考《终久享福的智慧》。
Tonight I'd like to study the topic "Wisdom for Long-Lasting Blessings" from the Book of Deuteronomy.
Ah.以色列百姓在埃及受苦。
The Israelites were suffering in Egypt.
所以他们向神呼求。
Therefore, they called out to God.
神说他听见他们的哀声。
God said that he heard their cries.
看见他们的受苦。
He saw their suffering.
知道他们的痛苦。
He knew their pain.
所以神下来要救他们。
Therefore, God came down wanting to save them.
要救他们到流奶与蜜之地。
God wanted to save them to a land flowing with milk and honey.
也就是当初他应许亚伯拉罕的那一块地。
Which was also the original land that he promised to Abraham.
那一块地就是主耶稣来所传的讯息，天国近了。
That piece of land is also the gospel that the Lord preaches, saying the kingdom of heaven is near.
这个天国就是神的国。
This kingdom of heaven is the kingdom of God.
神的国是流奶与蜜之地。
The kingdom of God is a land flowing with milk and honey.
如果神充满在我们心里面。
If God fills in our hearts,
神会与我们同在。
Then God will abide with us.
我们的生活是丰盛的。
Then our lives will be an abundant one.
我们的生活是甜美的。
Our lives will be sweet.
这就是我们信仰追求的目标。
And this is the goal of the pursuit of our faith.
在地上能够来享受神国的滋味。
Whilst on earth, we can taste the goodness of the kingdom of God.
最后我们要回到天家，就是神的作王的地方。
And in the end, we shall return to the kingdom of God, where God reigns as king.
这就是我们人生最后的目的地。
And this is the final destination of our lives.
回到父那里去。
Which is to return to the Father.
这个叫做活泼的盼望。
And this is what it means to have a living hope.
那我们要怎么在这一块应许之地能够终久享福呢？
How then can we enjoy long-lasting blessings on this promised land?
所谓终久就是从信主的那一天一直享受流奶与蜜之地，一直到我们离世那一天为止。
Long-lasting means to enjoy blessings from the day we believe in the Lord until the day we depart from the world.
这个需要有极大的智慧。
And this requires great wisdom.
啊，有的人开始享受到啊牛奶与蜜的生活。
Some people started enjoying the life in the land flowing with milk and honey.
觉得信耶稣很好，为什么你最近才报福音给我呢？
And they will say that, oh, believing in the Lord is so good. Why did you wait so long to preach to me?
邻居这么久了，你如果早20年，我就能够来享受这个福气啊。
Had you preached to me 20 years earlier, I would be, have been able to enjoy these blessings 20 years earlier.
所以在开始的时候，真的享受牛奶与蜜的恩典。
Therefore, in the beginning, many of us truly enjoy the blessings in the land flowing with milk and honey.
但是这个恩典如果要持续到离世啊，需要有智慧。
But for these blessings to continue until the day we depart the world, would require wisdom on our part.
好，我们现在来看啊，《生命记》的第四章。
Now let's turn to Deuteronomy chapter 4.
啊，《生命记》的第四章
，Deuteronomy chapter 4。
啊，第五节，请读。
Verse 5, Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5. Surely I have taught you statutes and judgments, just as the Lord my God commanded me, that you should act according to them in the land which you go to possess.
第六节。
Verse 6, therefore, be careful to observe them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the peoples who will hear all these statutes and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people.
第七节。
Verse 7, for what great nation is there that has God so near to it?As the Lord our God is to us, for whatever reason we may call upon him.
第八节。
Verse 8. And what great nation is there that has such statutes and righteous judgments as are in all this law which I set before you this day?
在第六节讲，你们要谨守遵行，这就是你们在万民眼前的智慧聪明。
Verse 6 says, Be careful to observe them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the peoples who will hear all these statutes.
世界上的人讲聪明，常常是指着地上的。
When the people of the world talks about wisdom, they mainly focus on earthly wisdom.
很会读书，很会计划，啊，很会，啊，来为自己的前途，啊，努力。
So if you're good at studying, good at planning, and good at working hard to achieve your goals,
啊，所以到30-40岁中年以前，已经比别人更突出。
And when you are 30 or 40 years old, stand out among the rest.
啊，这个是很聪明的。
So these people are considered very wise.
啊，但是圣经里面讲的是智慧。
But what the Bible talks about is wisdom.
哦，那智慧从哪里来？
I'm sorry, that's the understanding of the worldly people, but the Bible talks about wisdom. So where does wisdom come from?
哦，在箴言里面说，敬畏神是智慧的开始。
Proverbs says,the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord.
啊，所以神是智慧的本身啊。那我们是智慧的来源，我们开始敬畏神啊，我们才开始进到智慧里面。
God is a source of wisdom, and once we have wisdom, then we begin to enter into the fear of Him.
啊，所以这第六节讲啊，神的话。神的道要谨守遵行，这就是我们在万民眼前的智慧聪明。
So verse 6 says, Be careful to observe them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the peoples.
啊，没有一个人能够发明一套理论、人生哲学超越圣经。
There is no one person who can invent theories or philosophies that is beyond what the Bible teaches us.
因为人是神造的。
Because man is created by God.
万物是神造的。
And all things are created by God.
神造人，成造万物有他的目的。
God created men and created things for a purpose.
啊，有他的原理在里面。
And he has his He has his rules and laws in them.
哦，所以一个人如果明白神的话啊，他就明白我们在世界上应该怎么活。
So if a person understand the word of God, then he would know how he ought to live in this world.
那这样的人就是最有智慧的人。
And such a person is the most wise person.
啊，所以第七节哈。那一大国的人有神与他们相见。
So verse 7 says that what great nation is there that has God so near to it?
就是从其他的国家人来看，哇，这一国不得了，他有神跟他们同在。
So other nations look at the Israelites saying, wow, what a great nation, because they have God with them.
神的同在啊，就是天国。
So to have the abidance of God,is to have heaven.
我们大家都很想活着很幸福。
We all love to lead a blissful life.
但是幸福的关键就是要神同在。
But to have a blessed life, the crux is to have the abidance of God.
那神怎么跟我们同在？
Then how can God abide with us?
我们谨守他的诫命，那神就与我们同在。
So if we...observe his statutes and laws, then God will abide with us.
那神与我们同在，我们的生活就很丰盛，我们的生活就很甜美。
If God abides with us, our lives will be abundant and will be sweet.
所以我们的智慧从哪里来？从遵行神的话来。
Therefore, where does our wisdom come from? It comes from keeping and obeying the commandments of God.
那这个在生命记里面教导我们要终久享福神的话里面对我们有一些提醒，有一些建议。
So in the book of Deuteronomy, it reminds us of a few tips as how we can have long-lasting blessings.
好，我们先来看第六章。
Now, please turn to Deuteronomy chapter 6.
生命记第六章。
Deuteronomy chapter 6.
第十节到十二节
10 to 12.
请读
Verse 10. So it shall be when the Lord your God brings you into the land of which he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give you large and beautiful cities which you did not build. Verse 11.Houses full of all good things which you did not feel, hewn out wells which you did not dig, vineyards and olive trees which you did not plant, when you have eaten and are full.
Okay, 这个地方讲啊，这个是神应许给你的地。
So here says that this is a land which God promised you.
然后接下去就讲有诚意。有房屋，有美物，有水井，还有橄榄树。
Then it went on to say, beautiful cities, houses, hewn out wells, vineyards, and olive trees.
你如果把它想象哦，你就知道说这一种生活是非常丰盛的。
So if you imagine it, you know that such kind of life is a very abundant one.
但是这里特别讲啊，不是你建立的，不是你挖的，不是你栽种的。
But here it emphasized that you did not build, you did not dig, and you did not plant.
那不是你预备的，你又能够享福，这就是神的恩典。
So things that you did not put in any work or prepare anything, this is blessing.
所以以色列百姓经历40年，现在已经到迦南地的旁边。
So the Israelites have traveled 40 years in the wilderness, and now they're at the border of the land of Canaan.
啊, 神的应许就在前面,
and God's promise, and God's promise is right in front of them.
哦, 那前面这一块地啊, 是他们要享受福气的地方。
And this land is a place where they shall enjoy their blessings.
哦, 事实上我们信主以后啊, 每个人都得到神很丰盛的恩典。
In reality, after we believe in the Lord, we all have experienced the blessings of God.
所以如果我们把从信主开始得到神的恩典，可以写得很安满的一章。
So if we were to write down all the blessings that we have experienced from the day we believe, we will have filled up a full page.
但是当我们活在神的恩典的时候，要非常谨慎。
But while we live under the blessings and grace of God, we have to be very watchful.
请看第六章的十二节。
Let's now read Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 12.
请。
Verse 12, then beware, lest you forget the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage.
十四节。
Verse 14, you shall not go after other gods, the gods of the peoples who are all around you.
这个地方讲啊, 当生活在很丰盛的时候, 我们很容易忘记神。
So he reminds us that when we live in abundance, it's very easy for us to forget about God.
所以雅各祷告说, 不要让我太贫穷, 因为太贫穷很难守道。
Therefore, Agur prayed, asking the Lord not to make him too poor because it'll be hard for him to keep the word.
但是也不要太富足、太舒服。
But he also prayed to not let him be too comfortable.
因为这样会忘记神。
Because in this way, he may forget about God.
我觉得没有神,
and you may think that even without God, I can still live such good lives.
所以活在神的恩典有时候会忘记是恩典的神。
So sometimes, whilst living under God's grace and blessings, we tend to forget the God who had granted us this grace and blessings.
我们今天的生活是因为神的恩典。
We today can have such a standard of living all due to the blessings of God.
如果这个忘记了,
But if we forget this fact,
就会进到14节。
Then we will fall into verse 14.
随从别的神就是你们视为国民的神。
You shall go after other gods, the gods of the peoples who are all around you.
不一定是随着人去拜偶像。
So this does not mean that you will follow other people to worship idols.
生活有一些事情已经取代了神。
But it merely refers to some things that in your lives that have already replaced the importance of God.
比神还重要。
You put them these things as more important than God.
那这个就是无形的偶像。
And these things are the formless idols.
啊, 那如果我们忘记的是恩典的神。
And if we have forgotten the God who had granted us grace and blessings,
啊, 那去找另外一个来代替神。
And instead seek another thing to replace our God,
在诗篇里面说, 以别的神来代替真神的, 他的愁苦就会增加。
Then in the book of Psalms, it says that if one takes something else to replace the true God, then his suffering or anguish will multiply.
所以为什么我们活在神的恩典中, 有时候会保住很多的苦难。
So therefore, why is it that in our lives, suddenly pops up a suffering.
不是每个人, 但是有时候是因为我们用其他的,
But this does not apply to all cases, but sometimes it's because we have replaced God with other things.
所以只要我们不忘记神, 持守他的话语, 我们就能够终久享受从神来的福分。
Therefore, if we do not forget God and continue to keep His word, then we will be able to experience God's long-lasting blessings.
那如果有其他的来代替了神，那我们跟神的关系就有问题。
And if other things have replaced God in our lives, then our relationship with God will becomes problematic.
所以第六章的十五节。
Therefore, in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 5.
第六章十五节。
Oh, sorry, chapter 6, verse 15. Okay, verse 15. For the Lord your God is a jealous God among you, lest the anger of the Lord your God be aroused against you and destroy you from the face of the earth.
这里讲神是忌邪的神。
Here says that God is a jealous God.
所以神希望我们全心意全力的爱他。
God wants us to fully love him with all our heart.
如果神的恩典取代了神在我们心中生活中的地位。
So if the grace of God replaces the position of God in our hearts,
那我们就引起神的嫉妒。
Then we will arouse the jealousy of God.
那我们跟神的关系就有问题。
Then our relationship with God will have problems.
这是第一个，摩西提醒以色列百姓，今天也是提醒我们。在神的恩典中不要忘记是恩典的神。
Therefore, this is the first reminder that Moses gave the Israelites, which also applies to us, which is that under the grace of God, we cannot forget the God who actually gives us this grace and blessings.
第二个，神要摩西告诉以色列百姓，不要被外面的环境所同化。
And the second thing that Moses wanted to remind the Israelites is not to let the outside environment assimilate you.
好，我们看第七章的第一节。
Now let's turn to Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 1. Okay, Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 1. When the Lord your God brings you into the land which you go to possess and has cast out many nations before you, the Hittites and the Girgashites and the Amorites and the Canaanites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites, seven nations greater and mightier than you.
这个地方讲迦南地有七国的民。
This verse says that in the land of Canaan, there are seven nations.
非常强壮的民。
And they are great nations.
所以神要把这一块地交给他们。
Therefore, God would hand this land to them.
因此神要叫他们把这个七族人全部都赶出去。
Therefore, God wanted them to remove all these seven nations.
我们看第二节。
Now let's read verse 2. And when the Lord your God delivers them over to you, you shall conquer them and utterly destroy them.You shall make no covenant with them, nor show mercy to them.
我们要从信仰的观点来看这一节圣经节。
So we have to look at these verses from the perspective of our faith.
为什么要将他们击杀尽尽
？So why is it that they have to conquer them and utterly destroy them?
因为以色列百姓是神的选民。
This is because the Israelites were the chosen people of God.
这个神的选民跟在迦南地这个七族是不能够同时存在的。
And the chosen people of God cannot coexist with these seven nations of Canaan.
所以如果没有把他赶出去击杀尽尽，他们就会被这七族人所灭掉。
So if they do not conquer and utterly destroy the seven nations, then the seven nations would destroy the Israelites.
那个七族就是我们心里面的七情六欲、情欲。
So the seven nations refers to the passions and desires and sinful nature within us.
如果我们没有把情欲杀掉，情欲会把我们杀掉。
So if we do not kill the passions and desires within us, then these evil desires will kill us.
那这个七族人呢，有他的文化。
And these seven nations have their culture.
所以当以色列百姓进到迦南地，这个七族的文化，会让他们被同化。
So when the Israelites enter the land of Canaan, the culture and traditions of the seven nations can easily assimilate them.
我们在如果在看列王纪上当时先知以利亚的时代。
When we look at the first Kings during the time of Prophet Elijah,
以色列百姓都去拜偶像。
The Israelites all went to worship idols.
为什么？
Why?
因为周围的人都在拜偶像。
It's because the people around them were worshiping idols.
所以他们已经被周围的文化同化了。
So they had been assimilated by the culture and traditions around them.
怎么把他们带回来？
So how then can they be turned back?
虽然以利亚用很多的理论来说服他们，还是心持两意，不愿意选择，不愿意改变。
So although Elijah had used many teachings and rationale to try to turn them back, but they refused to repent and refused to change.
一直到他们看到神降下大的能力，他们才回心转意。
It was only until they saw God send great power from heaven that they changed their minds.
所以我们周围的社会环境，我们周围所接触的文化，是会让我们同化的。
So the things that we experience and see happening in our society can influence make us be assimilated to them.
因此主耶稣在最后分离的祷告，在约翰福音十七章里面，他最挂心的是什么？
So in John 17, in the last prayer of the Lord before he departs to heaven, what was the greatest worry of the Lord Jesus?
第一个就是门徒没有办法同心。
First was how the disciples were not able to be united.
第二个就是被俗化。
Second, he was concerned about them being secularized.
所以他才说，你们不属这个世界。
Therefore, Jesus then told them that you do not belong to the world.
但是你们不要离开这个世界。
But you are not to leave or depart from this world.
你们住在这个世界是有使命的。
Because living in this world, you have a commission.
要做盐做光荣耀神。
You have to be the light and the salt of the world to glorify God.
Okay, 要把福音传开来。
And you have to preach the gospel to all nations.
按着主耶稣求天上的神，让他们因为真理而成圣。
And the Lord prays that God will sanctify them by the truth.
所以我们在这个世界上不被同化，需要用真理来建立我们的观念。
So therefore, in order not to be assimilated or be secularized by this world, we have to be in the truth.
世界上有很多的理论学说。
We have to be rooted in the truth, because in the world, there are many philosophies and teachings.
但是这个都是会一直在改变的。
But these worldly teachings will continue to evolve.
你看我们家里面有哪一本书是一百年前人写的
？So look around your home. Is there a book that has been written some 100 years ago?
大概只有圣经。
I believe the only book is the Bible.
那是2000年写的。
It's been written 2000 years ago.
旧约是3000多年前写的。
And the Old Testament was written 3000 years ago.
这个是真理。
This is the truth.
所以我们的信仰不被同化，就是要用圣经神的话来塑造我们的观念。
So in order not to be assimilated to the world, we have to allow the teachings of the Bible to shape our thinking.
摩西学习埃及一切的学问。
Moses learned all the wisdom of Egypt.
但是我们看摩西写的五经里面，看不出来有埃及文化的味道。
But when we read the Pentateuch, or the five books of Moses, we don't even see any flavor of the culture of Egypt.
所以摩西的信仰是很纯的。
This is because the faith of Moses is very pure.
保罗受过加玛列的教育。
Paul had been educated under Gamaliel.
在新约圣经他写了13卷。
And in the New Testament, Paul wrote 13 books.
他把当时的学说叫做世上的小学。
And he regarded the philosophies of that time as the elementary teachings.
哦，所以他没有把当时所受的教育跟神的启示混在一起讲。
Therefore, he did not combine the education that he received in those days with the teachings of the word.
所以今天我们要保持信仰的纯正，不被同化。
Therefore, today we have to keep the purity of our faith and not to be assimilated with the world.
在哥林多后书里面讲，信仰不纯就是对神不贞洁。
In the 2 Corinthians says that if our faith is not pure, then we are not chaste before God.
啊，因为我们相信另外一个耶稣，相信另外一个灵，啊，我们信仰就不纯。
Because if we believe another Jesus or another spirit, then our faith is not pure and not chaste.
啊，那在第七章的第三节，特别在讲到婚姻问题。
And in chapter 7, verse 3, especially talks about marriage.
啊，为什么圣经会这么强调这个？
So why is it that God, the Bible emphasizes on this teaching?
因为最重要的观念啊，想法就是怕被世界同化。
Because the most important main teaching is for us not to be assimilated by the world.
啊，所以在生命记第七章啊，在里面在讲啊，在婚姻要跟相同的信仰结婚，主要的考虑就是啊，我们的信仰。
Therefore, Deuteronomy 7 verse 3 tells us to about marriage, and the main purpose is to maintain and keep our faith.
啊，甚至在新约时代，保罗在讲配偶离世的可以再婚。
Even in the New Testament, Paul says that if you are widowed, you can remarry.
但是他还加上一句话，要在相同的信仰里结婚。
But he added that you have to marry within the same faith.
啊，因此从旧约一直到新约，这是神的旨意。
Therefore, from the Old Testament to the New Testament, this has been the will of God.
要保持我们的信仰啊，不被同化。
We have to preserve our faith and not to be assimilated.
好，我们现在来看《生命记》第八章。
Now let's turn to Deuteronomy chapter 8.
第七章哈，回来第七章的第六节到第八节。
I'm sorry, Deuteronomy chapter 7, verses 6 to 8. Okay, verse 6. Therefore, you shall keep the commandments of the Lord, for you are a holy people to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you to be a people for himself, a special treasure above all the peoples on the face of the earth. Verse 7. The Lord did not set his love on you, nor choose you because you were more in number than any other people, for you were the least of all peoples. Verse 8. But because the Lord loves you, and because he would keep the oath which he swore to your fathers, the Lord has brought you out with a mighty hand and redeemed you from the house of bondage, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt.
啊，这里特别在提醒以色列百姓他们的身份是什么。
So here God especially reminded the Israelites of their status.
你们是神圣洁的子民。
For you are a holy people to the Lord your God.
地上万民拣选的。
The Lord has chosen you to be a people for himself.
啊，所以我们是圣洁的国度，是君尊的祭司。
So we are a holy nation, a royal priesthood.
是属神的子民。
A people belonging to God.
这是非常尊贵的。
So we are a very special and honorable.
好，那这个尊贵的身份从哪里来？
And where does this special status comes from?
第八节说，原来就是神专爱我。
Verse 8 says, because the Lord loves you.
啊。在第七节
Verse 7.
就是神对我们的爱。
So this is the love of God towards us.
所以神对我们有期待。
Therefore, God had expectations for us.
要保持我们的信仰纯正，不被同化。
God wants us to keep the purity of our faith and not to be assimilated.
好，那从第七章的九节到十一节。
And from chapter 7, verses 9 to 11.
看第九节。
Verse 9. Therefore, know that the Lord your God, He is God, the faithful God who keeps covenant and mercy for 1,000 generations with those who love Him and keep His commandments.
这里讲你的神是信实的，是向爱他、守他诫命的人，守约是慈爱，直到千代。
So here says that God is a faithful God who keeps covenant and mercy for 1,000 generations with those who love Him and keep His commandments.
所以一个人只要常常遵守神的诫命，神的爱、神的信实会一直持续到永远。
So as long as we keep God's word, God's love and mercy would extend for eternity.
好，那我们再看第八章。
Now let's turn to chapter 8.
第八章的第十一和十五节。
Chapter 8, verse 15.
请读。
15. Who led you through that great and terrible wilderness in which were fiery serpents and scorpions and thirsty land where there was no water, who brought water for you out of the flinty rock.
16节。
Verse 16, who fed you in the wilderness with manna, which your fathers did not know, that he might humble you and that he might test you to do you good in the end.
17节.
Verse 17, then you say in your heart, my power and the might of my hand have gained me this wealth.
18节.
18, and you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth. That he may establish his covenant, which he swore to your fathers, as it is this day.
为什么神要在旷野带领他们这样苦练了四十年？
So why is it that God led them and trained them for 40 years in the wilderness?
16节最后一句讲，为着叫你们终久享福。
And verse 16 says, so that to do you good in the end.
所以这些苦难就是要让他们在流奶与蜜记都能够永远享福。
So all these sufferings and trials is for them to enjoy long-lasting blessings in the land of Canaan.
为什么？
Why?
因为这些苦难可以看到神很清楚的作为，神很清楚的带领，所以他们知道我们今天在这里蒙福是完全出于神。
Because it's through this the sufferings that they were able to see the works and the guidance of the Lord. Therefore, when they enter the land of Canaan, they know that everything that they have is from God.
所以不会时间一过了就忘记了，以为这个是我们自己的力量得来的。
So that as time passes, they will not forget thinking that all these blessings is because of our own effort.
那人一旦忘记了神的恩典，人就会心高气傲。
And the moment a person forgets the blessings and grace from God, they will become proud.
那这样我们就没有办法在这一块牛奶蜜之地永远享福。
Then if that happens, then we will not be able to enjoy long-lasting blessings in this land flowing with milk and honey.
好，我们再来看第八章。
Now let's turn to chapter 8.
第三节。
Verse
3. 第二节开始。
Let's start with verse 2. And you shall remember that the Lord your God led you all the way these 40 years in the wilderness to humble you and test you. To know what was in your heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not.
第三节。
Verse 3. So he humbled you, allowed you to hunger, and fed you with manna, which you did not know, nor did your fathers know, that he might make you know that man shall not live by bread alone, but man lives by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord.
这40年的旷野是一种操练。
So this 40 years in the wilderness is a form of trial.
在操练当中可以看出人的心到底是不是真的愿意遵守神的诫命。
So it is during this trial that one can truly see whether a person truly wants to keep the word of God.
然后第三节。
And verse
3. 人活着不是单靠食物。
That man shall not live by bread alone.
乃是靠神口里所出来的话。
But by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord.
神所出，口里所出来的话就是神的应许。
So word, the word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord refers to God's promises.
我们人能够每一天活下去是因为有神的话，而不只是因为我们有物质的粮食。
So the fact that we all can live every day is not simply because of physical food, but it's because of the word of God.
所以神要摩西告诉以色列百姓。
Therefore, God wants Moses to tell the Israelites
你们已经到了迦南地的旁边
that you have reached the border of the land of Canaan
你们要持守神的诫命
you have to keep the word and commandments of God
这样你就可以在应许之地终久享福
doing so, you will be able to enjoy long-lasting blessings in the promised land
好我们看申命记十一章
Now let's turn to Deuteronomy chapter 11.
申命记十一章的第八节。
Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 8. Therefore, you shall keep every commandment which I command you today, that you may be strong and go in and possess the land which you cross over to possess.
第九节。
Verse 9.And that you may prolong your days in the land which the Lord swore to give your fathers, to them and their descendants, a land flowing with milk and honey.
这个地方讲神启示应许之地能够在上面日子长久，那是牛奶与蜜之地。
Here says that you may prolong your days in the land which the Lord swore to give your fathers, a land flowing with milk and honey.
第八节就在讲要遵守他的诫命。
And verse 8 says that you have to keep his laws and commandments.
所以这个就是终久享福的智慧。
Therefore, this is the wisdom for long-lasting blessings.
也就是谨守神的诫命。
Which is to keep the commandments of God.
并忘记赐恩典的神。
And never forget the God who had given us grace and blessings.
不要被外面的文化所同化。
And we cannot be influenced by the cultures and traditions around us.
心高气傲，忘记神。
And not to be proud and to forget about God.
唱诗。
Let's sing him.
A 364.
Now we shall pray together.
求主带领我们明天安息圣日的聚会。
We ask the Lord to guide our Sabbath services tomorrow.
愿每一个人充满着平安跟喜乐来遵守安息圣日。
And we pray that everyone can enjoy peace and joy and keep the Sabbath.
我们现在一起来祷告，时间到我就摇铃。
Now we shall pray together. When time's up, I'll ring the bell.